This is a perfectly clear ice sphere, and I made it using my 16-pound solid copper ice press, a project that absolutely pushed my casting skills to the limit, and I'll show you how I made it in today's video. But first, why did I use copper? Why didn't I use something easier to work with, like aluminum or steel or even plastic? The answer is thermal conductivity, a material's ability to transfer heat, and copper does this extremely well. Just watch how easily this melts a piece of ice. Copper is the second most thermally conductive metal behind silver, which is great for an ice press, but it's also really difficult to work with, so this is going to be a challenging project. Like most of my projects, I started this one in CAD to come up with a design that I thought would work, but this thing's only going to take me so far, so next, I need to make some 3D prints. These are all the pieces that I'm going to need to turn this thing into copper, and the different colors represent the different methods that I'm going to use to do that. The black pieces, I'm going to use lost PLA because they're by far the most complex. This purple piece is pretty simple, so I can just sand cast that. And the red pieces, I'm going to turn those on the lathe, but I'm hoping to cast my own bar stock. These are definitely going to take the longest, so I'm going to get started on them first. I'm sure you've all seen this by now, but this is a liquid ceramic that I'm going to dip the models into about 10 times over the course of about a week and a half. Well, that's going to take a while, so in the meantime, I'm going to cast this base. This is a pretty easy part to cast. This piece here is called a riser, and it'll supply the main casting with metal as it solidifies and shrinks. If I didn't use a riser and I just tried to cast this piece like this, then I'd end up with huge voids in it, which obviously isn't good. And I'll also be able to put in the lathe, which would be really helpful. That casting is fizzing like a carbonated drink because gas was absorbed into the metal as it was molten, so as it was solidifying, it was escaping and causing that fizzing. That means that the casting is definitely going to be really porous. I could have avoided that by adding just a little bit of this phosphor copper, but I didn't really want to do that because I wanted to keep the copper as pure as possible. I probably should have though, because now I'm going to have to do it again. Actually, I'm not. I just ordered some bar stock so I can use this to make a handle. And that base casting looks great, so now it's time to do some work on the lathe. Well, these things look great. There's something about machined copper that really does something for me. This one does have some porosity on the bottom, but it doesn't matter because it's on the bottom. No one's ever going to see it. This one was machined out of the bar stock, so there's no problems with porosity or anything like that. It just looks good, nice and solid. I was going to use this leftover piece of bar stock to make the piece that goes here, but I think it's a little bit too small, so I'm going to try to use the sprues on the other pieces that I'm casting. And speaking of which, those pieces are finally ready so I can get them in the kiln and start burning out the plastic. I like to use these old copper soldering irons to remove some of the plastic before I put them in the kiln. I like to melt down into the plastic and then come up along the side of the shell, and that gives a little bit of relief for the plastic, somewhere for it to melt into instead of just expanding and cracking the shell. These castings turned out excellent, and I'm really happy they're finally done. The bell ended up cracking a little bit on one side, and I think that was from shrinkage, but as far as defects go, it's actually not that bad. And in fact, I think it'll be a little bit interesting looking when I'm done, but hey, as far as defects go, I'll take that one. I got lucky it wasn't on my logo, so that's great. When I was designing this thing, I had to figure out a way for both of these pieces to fit together properly because they make up both sides of the sphere. And if they don't fit together properly, then the sphere will be off center and obviously that won't look good. This is a little bit more difficult than you might think because when you cast metal, it shrinks and it's difficult to account for how it's going to shrink. What I ended up doing is adding a chamfer along this edge here. There's also a little ramp inside here and that'll allow these two pieces to fit together perfectly. I didn't add a chamfer to the casting itself because I didn't know exactly what size to make it. Now I need to put it in the lathe and take little cuts until they fit together exactly right. Yeah, that's a perfect fit. That's exactly what I want. Now all I have to do is cut off the sprues, drill and tap a couple holes, and then start machining the dimples. It should be pretty easy to do. All I have to do is rotate my vise and tilt the head on my mill, and that'll be the first time I'm tilting the head, but it should be pretty easy. This project was a ton of fun, and here it is in its coppery glory. Everything went together pretty much how I had hoped it would. It just looks like $1 million. I could not be happier with it.
The final weight ended up being 16.5 pounds, and it feels like it. This thing's actually really heavy, but it needs to be heavy in order to work properly. I guess the only thing left to do is to try it out, so I'm gonna go get some ice.
I ended up making a whole bunch of these pieces of ice on my quest to make some that are perfectly clear, which actually isn't as easy as you might think. Yeah, I don't know why I brought all these pieces of ice out. I'm gonna go put some back in the freezer. So the way to make clear ice is you put it in an insulated cup and then you want it to freeze from the top down. And that pushes any impurities or air down to the bottom and then you are left with a section of clear ice. Now that didn't work every time for me. In fact, I only had about a 25% success rate. Now what I need to do is just cut off the excess and end up with something a little bit larger than the sphere. So that's about the right size. Now I just need to put it in the press and turn it into a sphere. All right, here we go. I love that. Look how quickly it's going. That's wild. That's it, it's done. Look at that, already. Ah, look at that. That's amazing. Wow. That is so cool. How cool is that? Wow. Perfectly round ice ball. I know, but it's like 10 o'clock. I can't start drinking yet. Man, that's awesome. Well, that was really cool, so let's do it again. This piece has some pretty cool layers in it. Let's see what it'll look like as a sphere. This thing is totally filled all the way to the brim. Look at that. When I went over to the sink to dump out the water, I used the faucet to heat it up with hot water, so I'm curious to see how well it'll work when it's warm. The water was about 120 degrees, so now this thing's pretty warm. It's so fast. Wow. I don't even know how long that was. Like 15 seconds, maybe? Yeah, look at that. Oh, that's cool. Looks like an eyeball. There you go. Yeah. See it? Looks like an eye. That's awesome. Wow. Man, this thing is so much fun. A friend of mine recommended that I try dry ice in this, so I'm gonna go get some dry ice and we're gonna find out if I can make some spheres with dry ice. That sounds really cool to me. All right, so I'm back from the store with some dry ice, so let's see what happens if I put some in here. So for those of you who don't know, dry ice sublimates, which means it goes directly from a solid to a gas and skips the liquid phase. So it'll be interesting to see what happens here. Oh. Whoa.
Oh my God. Wow.
That's crazy. Whoa. That's way crazier than I thought it would be. Whoa. That was insane. Wow, I was not expecting that. I was expecting a lot of gas to come up out of here, but I don't see any. It's probably full of CO2 in here, so I gotta open the door. But wow, it just broke apart. It's kind of spherical. That was way crazier than I thought it would be. So I got another piece here. Let's try it again.
Ah.
It just stops instantly. Look at that, it did actually kind of make a sphere. That's kind of spherical. I think if I had the right size piece of ice, it would work perfectly.
Well, that was pretty incredible. I didn't know what to expect, but I really didn't expect that. It was definitely worth trying out. I think it's worth mentioning that this is not my original idea. You know, I didn't come up with the ice press. When I designed this one, I borrowed some features from others that are already on the market. I did want one of these things, but they're so wildly expensive that I know that I just would never buy one, so I decided to make my own. I'm not trying to sell these, it's for my own personal use.
Before you go, I want to show you one last thing. This is a copper fidget spinner, and it's my very first metal casting. I'm showing you this because a lot of times I get comments where people say, there's no way I could ever make something like that myself. Well, that's not true. You just have to get started doing it, and before you know it, you'll be making cool things too. And you don't even need all the fancy tools that I have, because I definitely didn't have them when I first started. Anyways, I just wanted to show you that and reassure you that you can also do it yourself. You just have to try. Anyways, thanks so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks for hanging out with me while I made this crazy thing, and I'll see you on the next one.